down on our drawing toolbar, we have this item that says curve when I put my arrow over it. Bringing up the toolbar, it now shows line as the tool title. So it has curves and lines in there. Let's take a look at the curves first. To add a curve, I'm going to click on our curve icon, and moving on to the slide, I'm going to click and hold down my left mouse button as I go up and to the right. I'm releasing my left mouse button, and now I'm moving it down and to the right, where I will double click. There I have my Bezier curve. And I looked up the pronunciation of Bezier, and the general consensus on the internet was to pronounce it Bezier, so I'm going to call this a Bezier curve. We see these blue dots on the ends. Depending on how LibreOffice is set up for you, you might also see the green handles that we see when we place a shape out there. And to get back to the blue dots, I'm just hitting F8, which opens up our Edit Points toolbar. To know that F8 would bring up our edit points, down on our drawing toolbar, we see points F8. So if I hit F8, that brings up the toolbar. Now, if your toolbar is closed and clicking our points icon or hitting F8 does not bring up the toolbar, you can also open it in View, Toolbars, Edit Points. And then clicking the points puts us back into Edit Points mode. Going up to our Bezier curve, if I put my arrow on the right endpoint, we see an arrow with a little box to the right. And if I go to the left side, we see the same thing, an arrow with a little box to the right. If I click on this box, we see a dashed line leading up to a circle. Putting my arrow over the circle shows me an arrow with some string or rope intertwined. This is showing me that this is the control point for my Bezier curve, and the square is the endpoint. I can left click and move my endpoint, and I do have snap to grid on, and my grid is spread apart by half an inch just to emphasize the snap to grid. So my endpoints snap to grid as well as my control point. And when I move my control point, if I move it farther away from my endpoint, we see the arc itself getting larger. If I move my control point closer to my endpoint, we see the arc getting more shallow. As well as when I move it to the right, we see the arc going to the right or to the left. So it is controlling our arc. That's why we call it a control point. Coming down to the other endpoint, if I click on this one, we don't see the dashed line, but we do see the arrow with the string intertwined. If I left click and drag that, we see that we also have a control point for that endpoint. And it works in the same way. I'm going to add another Bezier curve, clicking the curve icon. I am right-clicking, holding down. I'm releasing my mouse and coming back down and to the right. But this time, I'm only going to single-click. Moving it to the right, I'm going to single-click again. Again, single-click and one more time. But this time, I'm going to double-click. So here we see our Bezier curve. And we have a straight line with some points. Looking at our edit points line, we have move points and insert points. Now to do that, I'm going to go up and turn off snap to grid. Let's start with move points. We can see that this one's already on, so I'm going to just grab this one and move it to the right. Now I'm going to insert a new point. I'm clicking on my line. And we see that it didn't do anything because it's already in a straight line. So what I need to do to insert a point is I need to click and move the line a little bit. Now I can move the line back down. And I have my point. Looking at this edit points line, over here on the right, we have eliminate points. If I turn this on, We can see the outline, so it is activated. What that means is if I move a point and then move it back to a straight line, that point gets eliminated because it's no longer needed for that straight line. I'm going to turn this off. And we'll do the same thing with this point. I move it up, and when I move it back to a straight line, the point remains because I have this eliminate points turned off. If I want to remove this point, we can see that it's selected. It's a little darker. I just come down to delete points, and now it's gone. Let's select this center point. And when it's selected, we see that we have these icons active. I'm going to move this down a little bit. And remember, when I clicked on this endpoint of my Bezier curve, we see the dashed line with the control point. In this side, we clicked, we see the intertwined string. So when I move it, we do have a control point. But on this corner here, when I click that, we only have the arrow with a box because it is just a transition point. If we want to make this a Bezier point, the first thing we can do is convert to curve. If I convert this point to a curve, we see that it's just like the endpoint. I've got a single control point, and when I move it, it makes a curved line. Another thing I can do is click on this corner point. When I click on the corner point, now we've got two straight lines, but I've got two ways of controlling the lines around the sides. And they each work independently of each other. Our next choice is smooth transition. When we click smooth transition, here we've got a nice rounded curve instead of the point we had with the previous example. This one's pretty similar. We've got independent control points. The only difference between this one and the corner point was when I click corner point, we've got a corner. When I click smooth transition, it's rounded. Our other choice here is symmetric transition. When I click that, it's similar to the smooth transition, only this time, when I move my control point out, both sides go out. When I move one side up, the other one goes down. And I can still move my transition point around. And the last thing on here is close Bezier. We'll just connect the line from one side to the other, clicking that. And that allows me to then fill in a space. Looking at the curve filled, that's similar to the curved line. I'm going to click, hold down my left mouse button, go up, release it, come down, double click, and it creates a filled shape. Now, if I click on this unfilled shape and give it a color, we see nothing happens. But with this shape still selected, if I say close Bezier, it closes it and keeps the color that I assigned it. Let's add another page. Insert slide. These other things here, polygon, they work the same way. I'm clicking on polygon. I hold down my mouse button, go down to where I want my first point, release my mouse button. Now I come up to where I want my next point. Click on that, and these are all just straight lines, and I'm just clicking, 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 and double clicking to finish, and that's how I make my straight line polygon. The one above is the same thing with filled shape. Polygon 45, that does the same thing, only I can work in straight lines or 45 degree angles. This last one, freeform line, this one works just by clicking and holding down, as long as I hold down that mouse button, I can draw a little line. The minute I release it, the line is created. And I can click on any one of these points and change this. Right now, it's a smooth transition. I can make it a symmetric transition. I can make it a corner point. I can move it out, make it a corner point. One more icon, split curve. Clicking that, this one just allows me to make two lines from one line. I just split it up and I've got two lines. Clicking off them, select one or the other, or holding down shift, I can select them both, as I do with any shape. And all of these points can be changed, even on the polygons, in the 45 polygon, I click on a corner point, I can change any one of these to any shape, deleting it. If I delete it from this corner, we see that it goes and the line just recreates itself.